Friends, welcome back to my channel. In our last session, we built this TL094 based power supply for this car audio power amplifier. How this power stage is configured. Here is NPN and PNP transistor push-pull amplifier to drive the speakers. Today we will see how this preamplifier and bus mixer stage works. We will apply power to 12 volt and remote on and ground here. This is the return side and this is positive. It is powered on. When we apply power, it will receive 35 volt plus minus 35 volt to make a dual power supply, positive and negative, because our these transistors 2 2 2 and 2, these are 8 transistors, and each pair NPN and PNP pair works as a push-pull driver for audio power output. This is power stage TL494 and these MOSFETs to drive this transformer, and then we have rectifiers here. We will receive plus minus 35 volt here. This is the basic requirement that it must turn on. After that, now we will check what are the prerequisites for this stage. Set multimeter to DC voltage and I will connect to the common wire here. Here we have two capacitors, 25 volt here positive and this capacitor negative 25 volt. So plus minus 25 to 35 volt will appear at these capacitors. These voltage will reach at these two rails, this negative rail and this positive rail. The same voltage are here at this negative rail and here at positive rail. When this power supply is reaching here, then we have two resistors here, power resistors, one here, the second here. Then it is reaching to the zener diode. One zener diode is here. This 15 volt zener diode. These two resistors, these are connected to positive and negative rail. This one zener for positive 15 volt and this zener minus 15 volt. These plus minus 15 volt are used for this preamplifier and for these stages, for these medium power amplifier stages, for push-pull audio amplifier. These voltage are reaching to these jumpers here and this jumper. This power supply must be present. And these two capacitors are here for positive and negative. Let's check here. Maybe the configuration may change in different power amplifiers, but the working phenomena will remain same. Positive 20, positive 15 and minus 15, the center line, that is common line. Common line will reach here. And this is our minus 15 volt supply and this positive 15 volt supply. These supplies will reach to these TL082 IC pin number 8, pin number 4 minus 15, pin number 8 plus 15. These are the important power supplies. These must be present. And here is TL084, pin number 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. and 9, 10, 11, 12. Pin number 12 minus 15, pin number 4 plus 15, all these ICs. This power supply must present. If any power supply will miss power, it will not work. These two TL082 ICs, it is two channel operational amplifier. TL084, it is four channel here. These will work to increase the gain for gain adjustment and to increase the bass. The same here, and these are preamplifiers. Audio signal, let's use audio signal. We can use oscilloscope. I will use this small speaker. I will use this audio signal of a DVD player for easy access. We will connect to this power supply ground. We can connect at any return line, because this return line is common for all the amplifier. Now I will inject to any one audio input to the audio connector. The signal reaches to this coupling capacitor and then it is applied to this network. The first input that is reaching here, we will check at pin number 1, that is for this channel, and we will check here at pin number 1 and pin number 7, same at this pin 1 and 7. It will generate different types of filters. We can see pin 7 of this IC. And this channel, it will reach here at first jumper, and it will reach to this capacitor. These two capacitors, these are the coupling capacitors for this stage. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are signal shapers. These will work as a driver stage for this push-pull power amplifier. First channel at pin number 1 and it is reaching here. The second channel. Second channel will come out from pin number 7. We can see it have so we can trace the problem here, that from where the signal is being damped. So we located that it have problem with this potentiometer, we will replace it. Now we can check the, and its signal will come out from the third connector, 1, 2, 3. This pin will reach from pin number 3, and now we will check the other side. This side, it will come from pin number 1 of this IC. And same way we will check from pin number 1, pin number 7, pin 1, pin 7. And it must choose must change its audio with these settings. Now we can check this one. This one is pin number 7. So pin number 7, this channel here, this all signal is being processed and it is reaching at the third connector. That's good. And this side, this channel, just we have problem in this stage that its signal is damped. So I think that was the reason that someone make jumper between this channel and this channel, because the problem is here. Someone modified that this audio signal processed from this channel is provided to bass resistor of this set. We will revert back. The problem is in this potentiometer, in this variable resistor. These are the checkpoints for this preamplifier. If we have audio signal reaching here at this point, the second channel is entering here, the third channel will enter here, and the next channel will enter here. Then this signal is directly coupled to this capacitor. Each capacitor will deal its own audio line, and then it will route to the specific IC, and we can adjust the amplification gain by means of these potentiometers and switches. Most of the time, the problem here in these potentiometers, because it is variable resistor, sometimes these switches. And next we will continue to this signal shaping circuit and medium power amplifier, then power amplifier. After processing the signal from this preamplifier, the signal reaches to these amplifiers. These are four amplifiers, one set, two power amplifiers and this network, second here, third here. We can also monitor the signal using oscilloscope. Same way we can connect common to the common of the power common, and so this audio signal will like this one, because its frequency is always changing. And this audio signal, its amplitude must change with change in this gain and when we will increase the gain, we can see the signal is increasing. When the signal is low and when we will change these settings, also the signal is changed. And next we will continue to troubleshoot these stages, because these are also damaged. Thanks for watching.